Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Coming up today and into the week, we can hopefully expect to see a few Starlink missions. The first of these, the Starlink 643 mission, is currently scheduled for today, Sunday 10th at 11:05 PM UTC or 6:05 PM EST. Then, just a matter of hours later, we should see another Starlink launch. The Starlink 717 mission is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 11th at 2:13 AM UTC or today, Sunday 10th at 9:13 PM EST. A couple of days after that and we can hopefully expect to see yet another Starlink launch. The Starlink 644 mission is currently scheduled for Wednesday 13th at 11:29 PM UTC or 6:29 PM EST. There was an article posted with some cool information about the lifespan of Dragon. It says NASA and SpaceX are looking to extend the number of flights that each Crew Dragon capsule can make from 5 to 15. Heading to Boca Chica, a grid fin was seen removed from Booster 4. There was work seen going on apparently for a parking garage. The work on expanding the Star Factory production building is continuing. There was some really cool information with a picture posted about Starship. It says SpaceX employees are getting rebar souvenirs of the launch pad that was destroyed during the Starship IFT-1 from 4/20/2023. Only 3,500 were made. This one was given to Ruben Stewart. As we saw last video, SpaceX performed a wet dress rehearsal of the Flight 3 stack recently. Chris Burgin posted some exciting information related to Starship IFT-3. It says the Flight Termination System squad is at the launch site. So, Ship 28 was recently destacked for the FTS explosives to be installed. Here's some footage of the FTS explosives actually being installed. There was also work seen being done on Ship 28's heat shield tiles. SpaceX posted some exciting information explaining what they'll try and achieve with the Flight 3 Starship launch. It says the third flight test aims to build on what we've learned from previous flights while attempting a number of ambitious objectives, including the successful ascent burn of both stages, opening and closing Starship's payload door, a propellant transfer demonstration during the upper stage's coast phase, the first ever relight of a Raptor engine while in space, and a controlled re-entry of Starship. It will also fly a new trajectory with Starship targeted to splash down in the Indian Ocean. The new flight path enables us to attempt new techniques like in-space engine burns while maximizing public safety. Ship 29 continues to be worked on the Pad B test mount. Starship 29 was also seen doing some testing of its forward flaps. Additionally, there was some testing of the aft flaps done as well. SpaceX did also attempt the Ship 29 spin prime test, but it was aborted. There was a part of a Booster 10 chine seen detached recently. Here's a view of Booster 14, which continues to be worked on in the Mega Bay. To finish up the video today, SpaceX have loads of possible closure dates to take a look at. They have possible closures for tomorrow, Monday 11th, Tuesday 12th, Wednesday 13th, and this is for testing, I imagine. Then, on what could be the big day, they have possible closures for Thursday 14th plus Friday 15th and Saturday 16th as backups. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, and Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.